Hello, and welcome to this YouTube video on different types of lasers that are used for welding. To begin with, let me start by sharing the screen so you can follow along on the PowerPoint. My name is Girish Kelkar, and I am a welding consultant operating as WJM Technologies, which stands for Welding and Joining of Materials. Here's my website, welding-consultant.com. where you can find more information about the training classes that I offer, consulting services, welding newsletter called the Weld Nugget, which has the same name as this YouTube channel, and the different types of industries and clients that I have. Today, we're going to talk about the different types of welding lasers that are commonly used in welding, such as CO2, YAG, fiber, and disc. The CO2 laser is probably the oldest technology that was used for welding. Since the 70s, 80s, and 90s, CO2 laser is a gas laser, and the tube is filled with helium, nitrogen, and CO2 gases. Even though CO2 is only 10% of the mixture, it is called a CO2 laser because it is the vibrations of the CO2 molecule that produce the lasing process. CO2 lasers, even today, are a popular choice for cutting, as they have very high beam quality and are still commonly available. The gas is activated by electrical discharge, and the CO2 light, which is produced by the laser, is a 10 micron wavelength. So the photons coming out of the CO2 laser are 10 microns in wavelength. One of the downsides of that is the CO2 laser cannot be transmitted through a fiber. It can only be possible for direct transmission through air. The other common technology, which was widely used in the 80s and 90s, was the YAG laser. YAG is a ceramic carrier, so yttrium aluminum garnet, and neodymium is the lasing atom which is there in the YAG rod of the order of about 1 to 2%. So here I'm showing you a schematic of the layout of a YAG laser. We have a lamp which shines a light on the YAG rod, and the lasing process happens in the YAG rod. There's a 100% mirror on the back end. There's a 90% mirror on the output side. And when the photons come to the 90% mirror, 10% of the photons actually leave the laser and are used for welding. The lamp can be a flash lamp for pulsed welding or an arc lamp for CW welding. The laser light produced by YAG laser is of the order of 1.064 microns, or 1 micron for short. And the benefit is that the wavelength can be transmitted through air as well as through a fiber. Now, transmission through a fiber, it makes life easier in manufacturing, as the orientation and layout of the laser allows a lot more flexibility. On this slide, I'm going to show you how the lasing process works in an animated form. Here again, we have the flash lamp. The light coming out from the flash lamp is shown blue in color. The lasing process, the lasing photons are shown black in color. And the red photons are the photons which end up going in the wrong direction and end up being wasted. So when I click the button, click the mouse, the process will start, and you can see the pumping photons are produced by the lamp. The black photons are going back and forth and getting multiplied. When they reach the output mirror, 10% of the output goes out and is conducted through a fiber. 90% is reflected back and gets multiplied. So this is the animation of a typical YAG laser. The new technologies which have come up in the last 20-25 years are fiber lasers and disc lasers. So the difference between the fiber laser and a YAG laser, the primary difference is that the pumping in a fiber laser is done with diodes. The benefit of that is the diodes can be finely tuned for absorption in the core of the fiber. And so first of all, we don't generate excess energy in the diodes. And secondly, the diodes don't need such high level of cooling as is required from a flash lamp. Combination of the two results in a very efficient laser of the order of 35%. So of the energy that you take from the wall, electrical energy, the output can be of the order of 35%, which is much more than 4%, which was common with YAG lasers. There are other benefits of fiber lasers as well. The beam quality is much better. The laser wavelength is 1 micron typical, but you can tune it for other wavelengths as well, including blue and green, and even 2 micron for welding of plastics. So there are a lot of flexibilities and opportunities with fiber lasers. The other technology which came about 25 years ago was the disc lasers. In disc lasers, the lasing action is produced in a disc, which is heavily doped with neodymium. And here again, the pumping is done with diodes. Otherwise, the layout is similar to YAG lasers. We have an output mirror, and the back end of the disc is the 100% mirror. And it is also quite efficient and very similar in many ways to fiber lasers. The technology is in producing the different wavelengths and powers is very, very similar. Here is a comparison chart of the four different technologies, CO2, YAG, fiber, and disc. I have bundled fiber and disc together because they are similar in many ways and in terms of quality, efficiency, and so on. In this table, there are multiple attributes on the left, and the values and qualities are listed in these different columns. If it's a neutral, I have left it white. If it is not so favorable, I have shown it as orange. And if it is favorable, I have shown it as green. So the wavelength is 10 micron for CO2, 1 micron for YAG, and fiber and disc can be tuned. Not the same laser, you have to buy a separate laser, but you can have fiber lasers going all the way from 0.4 microns to 2 microns. So that allows a lot of options with fiber lasers. In terms of electrical efficiency, here again, fiber lasers are shown as green because it is 35%. CO2 and YAG are not so good. The beam quality is good for CO2 and fiber and disc. Not so good with YAG, but I haven't listed it as orange because there are opportunities where a poor beam quality may actually be good for welding. And we will review that topic in another video in the playlist. Beam transmission in YAG and fiber and disc can be both air or fiber, so that's a good thing. Absorption of the metals at 1 micron and green and blue is good. Shielding gases. For welding, it's CO2. You need helium as a shielding gas, which is quite expensive and not easily available. Whereas YAG and fiber and disc, the welding can be done with either argon, nitrogen, air, or even vacuum. So there are multiple choices. Maintenance-wise as well, fiber and disc lasers are much lower in maintenance. Pulsed or CW, CO2 can be operated in both. Fiber and disc can be operated in both, but YAG, you have to buy it as a CW laser or a fiber laser. When it comes to safety, CO2 is the easiest because regular safety glasses, plastic safety glasses are sufficient to protect you from the CO2 light. For YAG and fiber and disc, you do require special protection. However, in most manufacturing situations, the lasers are fully enclosed, so safety is not as big an issue. If you look at this table, you'll realize that there are a lot of green in the fiber and disc lasers. And that is one of the reasons why this technology, especially fiber, even the disc laser at some point is likely to be not as good an option. And most of the lasers that you're going to buy going forward are going to be fiber lasers, especially for welding, cutting, drilling, and such. And you can see why. There are so many greens in these qualities in fiber and disc laser. Okay. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening. If you are interested in learning more about welding and joining, please subscribe to this YouTube channel, The Weld Nugget. There are other videos on specific topics and other playlists such as arc welding and resistance welding, welding and metallurgy. So please feel free to review those as well. Looking forward to keeping in touch and have a good day.